A new study by Robert Walters finds 74% of Filipino professionals are eyeing a backup job. That's in case anything goes wrong in their current career. The Global Talent Solutions firm calls this career cushioning, which it said is a growing trend in labor markets, including here at home. The study identified certain motivations for professionals who start looking for their next job, which include unhealthy work environment and low job satisfaction.
President Marcos has suspended work in Metro Manila's government offices due to incessant rains. Marcos also suspended classes in all levels as Typhoon Karina and the southwest monsoon bring continuous rainfall to the metro. Meanwhile, the suspension of work in private companies and offices is left to their discretion. The House of Representatives and Senate also suspending work for employees not involved in plenary or committee hearings. Floodwaters inundated several areas of Metro Manila, while rains are bringing rivers in provinces such as Oriental Mindoro to critical levels. Philippine Science and Technology Chief Renato Solidum Jr. says there is a 70% chance La Nina will develop by August. He adds the country must brace for stronger typhoons.
Ang una po nating ginawa ay magpatayo pa ng mas maraming Doppler radar. May 19 na tayo, 25 flood forecasting and warning centers. At ito naman po ay binibigay ng DOST pag-asa sa ating publiko araw-araw, and meron tayong climate forum para mas advanced na ang makuha ng ating Department of Agriculture.
An update on the weather now. Typhoon Karina continues to bring rains and powerful winds to parts of Luzon. Let's get the latest from Pagasa forecaster Rhea Torres. Rhea?
Good afternoon to everyone. The latest regarding this Typhoon Karina. As of 4 p.m., the center of Typhoon Karina was estimated based on all available data at 325 kilometers east-northeast of Basco, Batanes. It currently has maximum sustained winds of 150 kilometers per hour near the center and gustiness of up to 185 kilometers per hour, and is moving northward at a speed of 20 kilometers per hour. Due to the effects of Typhoon Karina, there is currently a tropical cyclone warning signal number 2 raised over Batanes. Meanwhile, signal number 1 is also raised over Cagayan, including Babuyan Islands, the eastern portion of Isabela, the northern portion of Apayao, and the northern portion of Ilocos Norte. Due to the effects of the enhanced southwest monsoon and Typhoon Karina, strong rains may be experienced over large portions of Luzon, particularly the western sections of Luzon area, as well as portions of Visayas. So citizens are advised against possible flooding or landslides due to the widespread to scattered rain showers. And based on our latest track forecast, Tropical Cyclone Karina is forecast to possibly exit our Philippine area of responsibility by Wednesday evening until Thursday morning. And we are currently, based on our forecast, we are expecting rains to continue over large portions of the country until this coming Friday. And that is the latest here from Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
Thanks, Rhea. The Philippine Senate President committing to approve the two priority bills President Marcos pushed for in his third SONA. Marcos on Monday called on Congress to pass amendments to the Electric Power Industry Reform Act, or EPIRA, and the Create More Bill. Escudero says he will make sure the two are approved before the chief executive's 2025 SONA.
Yan ang sisikapin namin gawin, lalong-lalo na dalawa lang naman yung binanggit niya. Maliban doon sa mga pinag-usapan sa LEDAC, dalawa lang ang binanggit niya na panibagong, hindi naman talaga panibago, batas na nais niyang makita ang ipasa ng Kongreso. Buong kumpiyansa ko, mapapasa namin yan bago sa susunod niyang SONA next year.